Hi guys, I passed my CCIE lab exam in May last year, so 7 months ago, and there are more and more people that ask me about some good resources and exam tips. In this video, I'm sharing with you the resources I went through for this exam, and of course, they worked for me, but I can't tell you 100% that they will work for you also. So please just take everything with a grain of salt. I was initially preparing for CCIE routing and switching and switched to service provider only after, so you might see some resources for the RS track. For me it was really good that I also went through those also, and maybe I would recommend you to do the same. And there are a lot of books here, but don't imagine that I've read them 100%. You sometimes only go through some chapters of a book, and it's maybe a particular topic that you want to get a second opinion on, or maybe a different view. Let's start with the routing part, the IGPs and the BGP. This routing TCP/IP volume 1 and 2 are great resources on routing in general, so I wouldn't only recommend these for someone who's going for their CCIE, but maybe also for someone who tries to better understand all the details of the routing protocols. Then, oops, something's missing here. I should actually have here OSPF and ISIS by Jeff Doyle. This book on OSPF and ISIS is for me one of the best books on networking I've ever read. So I've read the heck out of it, everything 100%, and I've also revisited it a few times, so I strongly recommend this one. This ISIS deployment in IP networks is an interesting book if you want to deep dive on ISIS. It's written by Russ White, so you can expect some good design approaches, and that's what it actually delivers. It's strong on the design part also. For BGP, I went with this BGP design and implementation, and I can say I was quite happy without it, but it didn't, I don't know, blow my mind, let's say, but it's decent, and it also covers a bit of these MPLS concepts. Let me also recommend you some videos. These are the Routing and Switching Advanced Technology classes. They are quite old, but I really recommend the routing part of this course. So if you see here, OSPF, Route Redistribution, BGP, Convergence Optimization, Routing, Multicast, and then also a bit of MPLS, they are really good for you to have a good foundation on routing. I went through these while studying for routing and switching. Then moving to the MPLS part, I'm sure you know this book, MPLS Fundamentals. It's the service provider Bible, and you really must read this from the very first page to the very last one. I strongly recommend this one. MPLS in the SDN era was actually a big surprise. I also really enjoyed this one, even though it's written by these two guys who work for Juniper, they also go through the ISXR implementation, and they also provide a lot of details on the features they're configuring, so this is also a really good book. By the way, I've had an O'Reilly account, and maybe I think 90% of these books, I found them on O'Reilly, and I really recommend you to do the same. So I think it's the best investment if you're studying for CCIE. The best investment is to have an O'Reilly account. For the RSVP or MPLST part, I went through this book. I just read, I think, half of it, only what I was interested on. And I actually just lapped a lot RSVP to really understand all of its features. It's not a difficult concept, let's say it's quite easy, but it does have a lot of options, and I just really took my time and lapped everything. There's also a good YouTube resource for that, for RSVP and for service provider also in general. It's called Lab Minutes. And if I also put here service provider, actually not like this, but Lab Minutes SP, you'll see that they have a lot of good resources on service provider. So this is their format. Then these CCIE service provider series from INE were very good on MPLS, core MPLS, then advanced MPLS and traffic engineering, intra and inter AS, layer 2, layer 3 VPNs, VPLS, and so on. So for the legacy MPLS protocols, INE is quite good. Then if you want to master layer 2 VPN, just check this tech note. These two guys work for Cisco, and I think they're the masters of layer 2 VPN. They really get into a lot of details and really explain every single aspect about layer 2 VPN. So I think this is enough to master layer 2 VPN for any exam. So if you download the PDF, I think it's just around 100 pages, but it's brilliantly explained. Then, of course, if we talk about layer 2 VPNs, we are also talking about eVPN. I first started learning eVPN by watching some Cisco Live presentations. And I did find some good resources here. There's a guy, I can't remember his name, that really has very good presentations. I think it's Jimmy or Jiri or I don't know, I can't remember exactly. But then I found out about this website, which Cisco is the main contributor, and you'll find a lot of presentation here also. Yeah, so his name is Chidi. He's a really good guy, and he explains eVPN very well. But you will still have some questions, and you won't find an answer for them, and that's the moment where you need to open this comprehensive guide. And the comprehensive here is really telling the truth, because this book has 3,000 pages, but it's the most inclusive book on service provider that's out there. So it really has everything. If you're searching for an obscure detail and you can't find that anywhere, you go check this book, and there you got, you'll have your answer. So I strongly recommend this book for anything in the service provider blueprint. Now, continuing with some next-gen protocols, Segment Routing Part 1 is a very good book written by Segment Routing Father. I think we can call him like this. Hopefully, I'm not butchering his name. He's Clarence Phil, I think. And that's based on how French people pronounce Paris. So it's Paris. Hopefully it's feel. Anyway, part 2, it's about the traffic engineering implementation with segment routing. And both of these two books are enough for the SP Lab exam, and they are really, really good. And by the way, I want to mention now, before I forget something, I didn't use any workbooks. They really don't work for me. I just make my own topologies, and it's easier for me to lab like that. So I won't recommend you any workbooks. Now, if you still want some videos for segment routing, I also have a course on pingfactory.com. This is my website. And this is the course. It's called Cisco IOS Segment Routing, and it covers both the basic segment routing part and the SRT part, as you'll also see under the curriculum. So it's SR, it's SRTE, and then this really interesting chapter, multi-domain scenario, where we're talking about BGP egress peering engineering, BGP link state, segment routing path computation element, disjoint paths, and so on. It currently has 10 hours of content, actually not 9, and it costs $15 plus taxes. You might be in a country where you won't pay the tax. And if you get this, you'll also get access to my Telegram group where we discuss everything based on this course. So I'm there for you to answer any questions regarding segment routing and why not about CCISP lab exam. Now I'm going to jump into a much loved, very loved topic. It's multicast and is written by the father of multicast. May he rest in peace. I think he passed away last year. This is a very good book to understand and learn multicast. If you think you would need a video to start learning multicast, you can check Cisco Live. They have some very good basic presentations. And then if you want to get into the details and the implementation, you should really check this channel. The contributor is Nick Bassin. You can check him on LinkedIn. I think he's now teaching for Narbic for his bootcamp. It's actually NIC and it's BHASIN. This channel really covers multicast very, very good. It covers both Cisco and Juniper implementations and it gets into all these details. This guy, not only that he's a triple CCIE, but he's also a JNCIE and he has great teaching skills. And that's it for multicast. If we are jumping to the multicast VPN chapter now, he also has some multicast VPN videos. They don't cover all profiles, but it's a good introduction into the multicast VPN concept. Then you have these two Cisco tech notes where you have the multicast VPN implementation on both XR here with all profiles and XE here with all profiles, actually iOS, but it's similar on XE also. And they are both written by Luke Tikhain, which is also the author of MPLS Fundamentals. And he also has some good Cisco Live presentations, I think, about segment routing, troubleshooting, Treesit, MRDP, and stuff like that. So definitely check these two links. And again, Nick Russo's book gets a lot into the details and cover most, if not all, the profiles. Then about the QoS, this book is really interesting because it shows QoS implementations and the design actually in different areas of the networks. So it shows you how you should use QoS in data center, in the enterprise, and in the service provider network. So it's really interesting. Then if you want to see how QoS interacts with MPLS, you could also check this book. It was quite useful and it also shows you iOS XR implementations. Then this, I don't know how to call it, article document, is quite short and it goes through the DiffServ tunneling mode. So uniform pipe, short pipe, you understand them really fast after you go through this document. For the automation part, I went with this guy. I had some Python and Ansible knowledge before starting learning for this exam, so I've just built on my knowledge, and there are a lot of resources for that out there. I've used these, they work for me. You can choose whatever you wish for the automation part, but what's actually more important about automation is the NSO part. You have these two websites, Developer Cisco Docs NSO, Developer Cisco Site NSO, which were really good. You also have the DevNet website, which I don't have it open right here, but you can check it on yourself. I also had some courses from Cisco about NSO, and you can also actually find some good content on YouTube about NSO. Make sure you download the image and install it on a Linux machine and really practice a lot. There are also some smaller topics like layer 2 connectivity with QNQ, Mac and Mac, RAP, STP Access Gateway, and so on. There's also HA and fast convergence, security, network assurance, those small topics. I've covered them by just going through Cisco's official documentation, so through configuration guides, white papers, and so on. If you're really struggling, you can also check Nick's book, The Comprehensive Guide, and I'm sure you'll also find some good resources there. And that's mostly it. I will leave all these links in the description, so make sure you check these below. If you have some other books that really work for you, or other content, video content that really works for you, go ahead and go through that. But if you're really struggling on finding some good content on a particular topic, maybe this will help you. That's it about the resources. In the next video, I will actually share some exam tips and maybe also a review of how it was when I took my exam. Thanks for watching and see you next time.